Hello everybody, welcome back to yet another video. In today's video, we're going to go ahead and start off a new series on this YouTube channel. I haven't done a series in a while just for the fact that it was at school and a lot of other IRL stuff, whatever. Long story short, we decided to go ahead and have one of these things here on YouTube. So, we're going to go ahead and record all my progress and whatnot through the Azteca world. One of my favorite worlds, just for kind of just how exotic it is. Like, I just like the way it is. Plus, I never actually add any Azteca content on my YouTube just because of weird issues with footage and a lot of other long story short, blah, blah, blah. Oh, well. Don't talk so quickly. Oh, well. We're also recording this live on twitch.tv/dtechboy. I do streams daily. So if you want to check me out daily on Twitch and whatnot and, say hi to me and interact and win giveaways or whatever. Link is in the description below to watch that stream. But we're recording it live on Twitch just because A allows me to have fun and interact with people like Pebbles the Wizard, Randon, Spider Sparks, Modern Laser, Prince Swag, Orphans on Orphans, Sparks, Pan Life Lord, a bunch of other people that are cool too. And also bring this video to you in, on YouTube as archive and also a way to, well, see it at a higher quality than what the Twitch stream is because of the way compression has to work for live streams. Versus YouTube, we can have high, nice recording or high local recordings that eventually go up to YouTube and then look really good. So, for those who do not know, I have a fire wizard. Yes, very original. And the reason is because I wanted to go ahead and test out, a more high aggression, high DPS type of wizard versus what I had before with a myth and a balance. I have those characters and they're more on the defensive support type of class or just more of a, not as a gigantic DPS hitter like fire and with all the deaths and stuff. So I've been wanting to go and play with this type of class, test that out and just have fun with that. And I've been liking it a lot so far on my stream over the months I've been on and off leveling that. So this is what I want to be leveling through Azteca. He's right now level 80. Didn't actually get the Avalon Spears yet, I'll do that later. But yeah, we have all the training points so far. All the spells for fire, including all the spells you can get up to now. Well, except for the... not Brimstone, we have that crafted and then Krampus, as seen a couple pages late. You know, Brimstone is crafted. And I have crafting rank up to, what's it called, Legendary. I haven't done the Azteca one since I need to do that, but I do have most of the materials for that, so it's not that bad. And we have Krampus, but I don't have Burning Rampage yet, since I haven't farmed that, and I'll be farming that later, so don't worry, I'll have that. Cameron, I already have a 110 myth and 110 balance, so I just am leveling up a fire. But I have all the other spells though, and training and whatnot, and all the draining points from Avalon, and all the previous worlds that are thus before, because that's how that goes. So we're gonna start Azteca here, and we're gonna go and talk to Cyrus Drake, go ahead and get all that stuff. I almost forgot to turn the dialogue on. This is when you know you've been speed questing and you don't care about dialogue. I mean, dialogue though is a cool one overall. Let me actually make sure this is equal. Okay, it's about equal, according to my eyesight. So let's go and do this and have fun with Ryan Firestaff, the Golem Breaker, and oh yeah, I forgot to show all this gear, sorry about that. This first episode and the first part is going to be very, very rambly, but then again, the whole series is probably going to be full of rambles, so excuse any rambles there if you are not a fan of them. If you are, then you're in the right place. If you're not, then bear with me. Yeah, but yeah, when most people don't care about questing, then you turn off dialogue, but that's because of speed questing, or at least just chilling on stream. That's how that works. I'm using the Avalon crafted hat, is the knightly helm. I like this because it gives more critical and damage and elemental resist, and that's what I like to wear. I also have the fire starter's hood, which is good as well, but like I like to want more damage and some more critical. Granted, the overall defense and overall accuracy is nice too, but it's okay for me. If I need to switch up to the other one and have healing and come in, then I'll do that. Excuse me, had some Pepsi earlier, so I might burp by mistake. Robe, we have the zigzag offensive robe here. I like the way this works, it's really nice. 20 damage, fire convert, some critical. Not as much as resist as the fire starter robe, but I didn't get that because I was lazy to farm for that. And some power pip chance, which I really, really like. And I believe more health than the other robe. It works out well. Granted, I also have this crafted as well, which gives a little more critical, but a less damage. And this has some block, though. So if I'm having issues against like ice or storm bosses or whatnot, I could do that. And it has a little more health, and actually overall resistance is better. So it depends if I want to go with that. I'll just lose a little bit of damage, though. Boots, we're using the block boots from Avalon, just because they're more practical, and that's what we're using. And that's how that goes. And then versus this, the block is really, really nice. So keep that in mind. Wand, we actually should be using a different wand, but I had this part of the gear set. When I was close to the 60 range, I redeemed my level 60 mystical flute. It's like the fire balancing one. I do not know the exact type name, but it looks cool though, and I like it. And I should switch this over to a better one once I get to a nice level where it's viable to stitch, or at least worthwhile in crowns, even though you can earn crowns here or go to the trivia or just buy them. I'm cheap, so whatever, that happens. Then I have random wands I should probably store in my bank, but I'm lazy. Like this one here, it's coolish. This one is from questing, I've been lazy to get rid of it. Or put on my wall. This one from like when I was questing level 10. This one from randomly getting it. I got the flute from the Mega Bundle a while back. Just didn't redeem it until a few months back. Random wand that I should get rid of. Another random wand. Another random wand. I used to use this, but now it's not that practical. Another wand of this. Actually, I might have had a wand that was practical that had more block. I might have deleted that. Oh, if we get a block wand that's better than 50, then we'll get it. But for now, we'll use this wand because I got rid of another one that had like 73 block, which I should have used, but oh well. And then, oh yeah, before I show other stuff, I gotta show the theme and ring. Sorry about that for the rambling. But yeah, then we have the Orphan Story, a theme thing. 24 incoming, and then 7 damage, and then 9 block. The important part about this is the incoming. It helps out when soloing and having Satyr to heal yourself. That's what I like, and it's from crafting. Works really well, and I like it. Life Mastery, just because, well, I do not have a natural form of healing that is not Link or Power Link, so we use this to use our Satyrs and Fairies and stuff. I mean, this is if I just want to have a balance blade, an additional blade to use in battle. This here is useless, that should just go away. Presto. Nice, 1000 gold. Then here is the ring we use. This is the Toasty Band of the Fire Elves that we will be using. This is a beautiful ring that gives energy, and used to be the best energy ring out there for the class. This is the fire one, but now there's Aphrodite and it has better rings, but oh well. And it's what we use until level 90. When we get to level 90, we'll have Alpha and Omega ring, standardized ring, 10 damage, universal, and all the good stuff that it comes with the ring. And then we have random wings that I don't need anymore. Well, yeah, we also have the Seal of the Shadow Pal, so if we want to change our rings over to this one for like the more sockets, I believe? Yeah, more sockets, we can have that when we get to 99. Do I have the Blade of the Felt Titan? Oh yeah, we also have Blade of the Felt Titan here. So that's what we have when we get the 90, which is the best a theme until later on. Pet, we're using a triple damage proof fairy pet on Enchanted Armament. This is really useful. It gives me the ability to have more blades and be able to kill things faster, either solo or assisting people. Really nice. The only issue with this pet here is this, it's a fake 9 dealer. And it doesn't actually give me the full 21 damage, it gives me 20 damage. I've been lazy to retrain or make a pet that's better, that doesn't have fairy or just plan outright. It actually has better stats, which this is the stat page right now. It's just got really bad with RNG, and the way the formula works is kind of weird. And I don't have a socket on it because I don't need to have one, and I don't have a spare one, so whatever. We also have a random pet I should get rid of, but I'm lazy. We have a failed attempt number one at a pet. Sadly, this got piercing and also didn't get proof defy. Like, this was close to being triple damage, double resistance, but no, my luck was bad. Like, this would have been good if I had a 10 proof, or just like, oh yeah, this would have 10 proof because of the stats it has, but like, it would have been nice if it had 10 proof and whatnot. Face cam's off for YouTube recording we're doing, so keep that in mind. So if this thing got piercing, not piercemonger, but like the pierce talent, then, and it got proof, this would have been perfect for me. But no, it did not, and I'm unlucky. Then the same thing happened over this pet, and I got really salty as well. And then it was PJ Saltland. And random base pet that I need to go and mix with other things, and then eventually get like my dream triple damage proof defy pet. Now we have Skywaver, Tiki Wave Runner, and then the skates. And then decks, just random decks. And then here's the overall stats that we have right now. They will most likely be changing over the progression of time. It should be 82 if I had proper 21 damage, but no, because of pet RNG. And then this is the rest of the stats. So, and then 6x power pet percent because we're cool like that. And 21 incoming. Or 24, sorry, I'm blind. So enough rambling and enough explaining and all that stuff. I'm sorry that it was so long. I will hopefully have an annotation to the point where I actually start without explanation. But for those who were curious, before we have all the comments going, oh, blah, 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 about what you tell me the blah, blah, blah thing, get the idea. We're going to be polite in that essence, or at least to the best of the ability. Have a good one, flying sparks, and hopefully you'll come back with a nice stomach that is not starving. So we're going to talk to Cyrus Drake and do all the fancy stuff and see what he has to tell us, slash the Azteca quest. What was the first star I seen? This one.
An old colleague of mine, Edward Haley, appears to be in trouble. He's what you might call an Azteca sorologist.
You don't know what that is?
Well, when you find him, feel free to ask him all about it. You can reach Haley's observatory via the Stella Itzamna. That's a large stone slab kept in the Royal Museum in Malibu. Go there now and make sure he is safe. Hello,
Legionnaire Romulus. Apparently I have that. We'll tell you more. Okay. I did not do the quest, apparently. That's funny. Oh well. Someone said to port over because they had the ability, or were really close. So we're going to use the powers of the viewers of Twitch TV to help us quest more productively, or at least teleport points. So we're going to use Stella, Sema, Vesadamia Thingwobber. I'm terrible at pronouncing things, so keep that in mind. Then we're going to go to the Haley Tower.
Those are some of Morgant's hideous bugmen. Quick, you better
Yeah, let's deal with those people. Why don't you? There we go. So we're gonna do that. I love the Marley Bone music. It's so relaxing. I love it. And then we have immediately a army of people coming down. Actually, if everybody attacks all, come on. Come on, let's go. Let's go. There you go. The team all up. So we're gonna go ahead and see how long it's gonna take for us to do Azteca with all sorts of fun people randomly throughout. And oh yeah, I forgot they have resistance. I forgot how big that was. Actually, these aren't even beat mobs, dang. But then again, I'm used to having piercing on 110 myth and balance, and that kind of just solves all the issues really easily. Hey Lorais, how are you? Hope we're doing well. We're just doing some Azteca stuff on the Fire Wizard, the Ryan Fire Staff. With an ugly Stitch, because we're lazy to do that, and also I'll Stitch when we get good gear or whatnot, or like, well, or when we have more of a solidified set of gear, and or when I get crowns, and or all the above. I'm lazy. Maybe I'll just eventually just get, do it just for the sake of people's sanity.
By the Spiral, thank you for safe. I had just received the most unusual visitor when those brutes appeared and attacked. Yes, a Quetzal arrived with a message tied around her neck. What's a Quetzal? They're a type of winged snake from Az. They're all extinct now. Well, they're supposed to be. Maybe this one hadn't heard. Quetzals were known to be vicious and protective, or occasionally tame. I'll let you find out what type she is. If you gently collect the Quetzal from the garden, we can have a look at the message she's carrying.
Ah, Quetzals. I love the Quetzal type of enemies. They're really awesome, and they also have a great pick. No, I will not make another character. We're already in the process of leveling this one up, so the same.
You step up to the Quetzal. She's some sort of winged snake. A little bit cute, even. She seems to like you.
Yeah, I know that's a friendly Quetzal instead of the aggressive ones that are in Azteca. I'm looking at you. The myth ones, especially.
Yes, well done. Now try to slip the message. Ah, you got the message and didn't lose any fingers. Good, good. Nice, Quetzal. Clever girl. It says, great magicians of Bartleby, Azteca trembles in the shadow of Xibalba. Please come at once for our salvation. It is signed by three names, Pakal Redmask, Tezcat Three Star, and Zaylin Reedwalker. Why, there's a spiral key here. I thought they were all lost when Azteca was destroyed by a great comet a decade ago. But perhaps we were all wrong, and Azteca persists. Quick, let us look through the telescope at the top of the observatory.
And off to the telescope we may be going. I love this Marley Bone stuff. It's really, really good. So mysterious and beautiful. I love if there's a Marley Bone expansion in the future. That'd be very, very nice. I just like the world Marley Bone. It's for just the way it is, and we're going around in circles, aren't we? I also like this area too, it's pretty cool. I like the dinosaur and stuff they have as well. Yeah, I forgot Quest Arrow is a little weird in this area. Don't worry, we'll eventually figure out how to get out there. Oh, there you go. See? Term eventually is pretty fast in this case.
You see a new spiral world, or more accurately, a very, very old world. The comet that encircles the world looks like a bad omen to you.
Indeed it is. Indeed it is, for sure. I'm gonna say, wait, is there a Quetzal there now? This is like some Azteca armor, looks like. But yeah, like I haven't came through the time I actually explore this area a lot. Forgot how nice it is. At least I like the way it's organized and whatnot. That's just me though. That was weird. Whatever.
You were able to see the spiral world? For the longest time, I could only see a cloud of dust in the night sky. The Aztecasaurs are the oldest race in the spiral. Their ancestors lived in the first world before it shattered. I assumed Azteca was lost, but perhaps there is yet hope for the Aztecasaurs, a wonderful, creative, and fierce people. I'm reminiscing too much, aren't I? You must take this Quetzal and her message back to Silas Drake at Ravenwood immediately.
And thank you, Thomas, for being awesome. And there we are with Cyrus.
Oh, finally, the wizard returns. What do you have with you? A Quetzal? I had no idea Azteca still survived. It is a place of the oldest powers and greatest legends. This message you recovered is fascinating. Clearly a cry for help. Someone really should investigate and see what is going on. You would best bring this news to Headmaster Ambrose.
Yeah, so we'll bring the news over to him. But I really like the way the Quetzal just stays there for like ever. Like the Cyrus literally just takes him in as a pet, and he just looks cool like that. Like the animation of them are just like awesome. I think they're one of the coolest creatures ever. There's also Quetzal pets if I recall properly. Maybe I should have one of those and have them on like a wizard or something. Would be really cool to have one, I guess. With like good talents or not.
Well, wizard, did I just summon you? Cyrus sent you here? Is it myth-related? A Quetzal messenger from Azteca. You say the poor creature was being chased by Morgant's minions. Oh, very worries. Let's take a look at that message. Oh, my. A plea for help against the forces of Shadow. Years ago, Azteca was cut off from the rest of the spiral by a great comet. Many believed it was destroyed, but I was not so sure. The spiral now reveals this world to us in its darkest hour. It falls upon us to act. Take the key this brave Quetzal brought us and travel through Bartleby's spiral door to Azteca. Find this Pakal Red Mask and bring light to drive away the shadows. Go quickly, young wizard, but be careful. I suspect Morgant's hand in this somewhere.
That is a true statement from Headmaster Ambrose, for sure. It is troublesome. So let's go ahead and go to the Zocalo and talk to Pascal Redmask. We'll actually use the spiral door. You guys are trying to be nice and like, oh, I'll be the board marker of all, but I will do my thing. Actually, are we on Northrist Realm? Yes, we are. Good. I love that realm. It's a beautiful realm. Let's talk to Pascal.
By Mother Moon, I cannot quite believe it. I was afraid I would remain alone and be forced to see our light extinguished. I am Pascal Redmask, but as you see, I stand alone at the edge of the City of Three Winds. My allies, Teskat Threestar and Zaylin Reedwalker, are lost. The comet Shibalba brought the Shadow Queen to Azteca, and she has laid waste with her Umbra Legion. My allies are gone. I beg your help. Confront the crazed Thunderhorns at 3 points beyond the Zocalo and learn what happened to Teskat Threestar.
Either way, we're gonna go ahead and do some of those fun defeating Kletic quests that we all love and admire and worship in this game, otherwise known as just do what they say and then just go with it. So we'll do that over here and we're gonna have some fun with that. And trying to be fancy does not pay off, by the way. It is troublesome. Bro, are these guys fire mobs? Again, they're fighting now. Oh, they are fire mobs. Raised Thunderhorns, I forgot. It's been a while since I've attacked these guys. They're fire? I don't care. I'll just go in the battle. Run! For my fun of the life, as they say. I don't care. I'll just go ahead and have my imaginary piercing stat. Just saying. Well, if I had Pierce jewels, I would put them on my gear, I guess. And then have Pierce. I don't know. I know TC Mass Prisms are beautiful things, which I should use more. But I don't, because I'm lazy. But we can all attack first, but nope. Don't do the attack because fourth one's on here. Well, that's practicability. Good to know. I still love the fire, what's it called? Colossus, I think? Yeah, Colossus. Like, I wish that's trainable. I really do. It's so cool looking. And it's pretty classical, like, from all the, what's it called, Dragonspire Age and stuff. And I just remember it singing everywhere. And it brings back memories, I guess. Ifrit's cool too, don't worry. We'll use that as well in the future. In the near future, as they say. Now we can attack. Presumably, yes, would be the case. Oh, they can use it on me? Oh, I see, never mind. Oh, sorry. Oh yeah, I forgot. Yeah, they can use it on me. That's the annoying part, but hey. Just go ahead and believe that they'll be nice mobs for now. We're gonna have to come back to them eventually and then find the funds of what happens when they use it on you. If only we had the original Malister 100k health fight and had it where like it locks you down to level 50 to fight him and all the things that are available at 50 or something, that'd be nice. I talked about this before, but that would be something I would like. This personally, I think that would be awesome. And then again, those were just my two sons. Which you either can like or decline and do whatever you want. You could say. Hey, through the powers of Tempest and Fire Dragon, we've won the world.
Shadows! Chase him into the maw.
Thank you for the informational mob. Or information mob. That's cool. They stalk back to Kaskel and report the news that they've told us. Oh, by the way, this is one of my favorite things in that saga, this like mini-game sigil area. Like, this is just awesome. I made many jokes about calling this with nicknames of the magical floating coin of duty, and he's in the way, but oh well. I like it the way it looks. It looks beautiful. It is really nice. I also like the way this passageway is from like the spiral door over to the area that is the 3 points. It's beautiful.
Tescat fled into the maw. That leads underground, where the hungry dead start.
When the comet Xibalba first appeared in the sky, 10 cycles passed, the Aztecas or oracles pronounced doom. So they fled underground to live in the mines and dwell among their dead. The maw is the entrance to the caverns of the cenote. But when the Shadow Queen arrived, the dead awoke, and they were hungry. Let us speak closer to the city. Meet me in the Zocalo proper.
There we go, we'll meet her in the proper place. I think it's a her. I do not know. I never asked the question or cared much. Thought I could have known it's Pascal. Well, hey, maybe I want the new NVIDIA Pascal stuff. Maybe that's what I'm doing secretly. Who knows? Yeah, I know it's pronounced Pascal, but I like saying it my way. Bleh.
While the Shadow Queen has left the City of Three Winds, her Umbra Legion has agents everywhere. It is crucial we find Tezcat Freestar down in the cenote to make sure he is safe. You can get there through the maw.
Let's go and get to the cenote. I think we have to do all this stuff to get to the cenote if I remember properly. It's been a while, if I recall properly, but hey, it's whatever. Because they have to clear locks or something.
It looks like it was deliberately caved in by something powerful. Maybe Pakal Redmask knows another way in.
Okay, Pakal, tell us the ways of fixing rocks with magic or whatever. You seem to know everything about the world, Kibo. Actually, I don't know. I mean, Pakal does know a lot of things. It is true. Joris Rex, how are you? Hope you're doing well.
Rocked off?
It's a him, okay.
What a dastardly diversion! Find the alchemist Sheepley Tailbiter in 3 points. He's a bit different, but he might have a good idea for clearing your path.
Okay, let's talk to the alchemist guy. He knows all, apparently, about alchemy. Because, you know, alchemist says up there. I'm laying my mouth.
Strange creature, can you make an agreeable sound? Can you understand me? You need to get through the rubble to rescue Tezcat Freestar? Into the maw? I can perhaps help you with that. If you will help me gather some ingredients, I can make you a strong concoction. Go to Lack Willow's Smoke Eye and ask for salt of stone, then Kanaka Sweet Chalet for sulfur, and charcoal from Hoteka White Ash. And then you'll see Tezcat Freestar.
Then we shall do that, and get all the ingredients we need for way to solve our issue and predicament over there.
Shipley Tailbiter sent you for some salt of stone? I have some that's been boiled down, filtered, and sun-dried. Yes, you can have some, but, well, make sure you don't stand too close when he performs his experiment.
That is nice to know that it has happened. Let me double check. Oh, I just have to go over there. Okay, oh yeah, also the crafter guy is over there. We'll talk to him in later when that's more proper to do, and I guess I'll... Well, actually, I need a potion trap TC, and I don't believe I have one. If I do, then we can immediately do it really easy. No, we don't. Okay, oh well. We'll work with the potion trap stuff when we get potion trap randomly from the mobs. Actually, my TC full? No, it isn't good. So we're good, I guess.
You need some sulfur for Shipley Tailbiter? I would like to help you, little one, but the crazed Thunderhorns took it from me. Perhaps if you confront them in 3 points, you can get some sulfur from them.
Crazed Thunderhorns, we're going back after you, because you have sulfur, and we need the sulfur. Is, you know, sulfur is important for our quest, and also we're forced to, no matter what. So hooray for life's decisions being what they are. Sorry about that, I was looking on Discord. Hey Skrill, how are you? Hope you're doing well. Just enjoying some casual Azteca funds. Oh wait, sorry about that, about the video. OBS messed up. Darn OBS, why do this? If you want to help out, sure, just give me a true friend code. True friend codes are accepted, man. In general, you can do that. That's okay with me, I don't really care. Whatever works for you, I guess. Like, I'm open to anybody, in all honesty. We're just chilling, essentially. AKA 8727, how are you? Hope we're doing well. Don't worry, ads are just the way the world works. You like them or hate them, as they say. I just changed my title and mentioned I'm actually doing the this is also for a YouTube recording thing too. Because it is, for those who are unaware. Because I've been wanting to put some stuff on YouTube and whatnot, and I've just been really lazy, but since we're starting this world, I thought it would be a good idea to do that. Whatever you would have more fun with, Prince Swag, or whatever you want to farm more, in all honesty. Another TFC from Brandon? Sure. Hello. There you go, Brandon Lewis. Oh, Lewis.
Brandon Lotus, my
derping tongue has done that again. Interesting bet. FM, cool. Intriguing, to say at least. This is Azteca. Pretty cool world in my opinion. I just like the way the story goes and just how it is with Morgantha and all that cool stuff. Has a lot of areas actually, which I like. Like, I like the areas and the way the teleporters work and whatnot. I just am a fan. But then again, I'm weird, so whatever. I like things a lot. Try to be as positive as possible. James Stormblade, welcome to the friends list, and let me load you up. Level 100 arena, cool. Well, we'll talk about the ending later. Ending's interesting, we'll say. Yeah, over 100, nice. Let's go on the Red Panda server on this card. Oh yeah, for those who are watching the YouTube video, and whatnot of this. Did I talk? No, okay, yeah, that's three. If you're watching the YouTube video version of this and whatnot, we do have a Discord server, so if you like Discord and want to talk to me on VoiceOver IP application on Discord, or just chat in our chats and stuff, I have one. I'll put that in the link of the description below. I haven't actually been doing that lately, but I'll add it to my auto link thing, or my auto description thing, so I don't forget it in all the future videos. As long as I remember to add it initially, then we're good. If we're not, then well, it's not going to go out that well, I guess. Well. I mean, I like food too, don't get me wrong, food's good. Hey look, they love the spell a little too much. They're gonna critically on me, hurrah! If you like, comment, and subscribe. All battles. Oh, that's great. That's true. Yeah, people do whatever they want on YouTube. As long as they enjoy the content, that's what matters in the end of the day. All that matters. I need to stop looking at Discord, but Discord's so interesting in terms of conversations. Why? Why does this happen to me? I do not know. It's weird. Hooray for someone not doing something in the battle and then leaving in the last second. That's always a fun time. Yeah, as you can tell, well, hopefully. I'm not the biggest fan of when people don't actually choose spells early on. It's a waste of time, but maybe that's just me and my speedrunner mentality is coming out. It's like, no. Sure, Sure, I would love a cookie. Digital cookies are fun. Granted, we all have digital cookies because of the way the things work.
Distracts Riot.
Ah, funny man. Funny man you are. Funny man you are. Well, by the way, we'll actually use converts if I am soloing this, which we will have solo moments, and I will have that. For now, we're streaming, and people seem interested enough in helping me out, so that's what we're doing for now. Like, we're not going to go on the super... We're independent fire wizard man guy thing mode. We're not going there tonight. Maybe tomorrow, or maybe later the stream, who knows. Or the YouTube video recording. It's weird, I normally say stream because, well, I'm streaming normally, and that's just how that goes. It's weird. Well, that's just my opinion, though. And that's just since I was school. School's good, man. Woman. Get the idea! It's been good. I'm actually on spring break now. That's why I'm actually streaming at a good time and what, and not doing lots of homework and whatnot. Thank you for the deal. That's why we're being productive for the most part. Or at least we're going to try to be as productive as possible while doing our live streams and whatnot on Twitch and then doing YouTube recordings and whatnot. Speaking of YouTube recordings, other than this one we're doing here and whatnot, I also want to go ahead and record some tutorials and whatnot. I need to do that. There's a lot of cool things you can do with tutorials and stuff. Interesting. Intriguing for you, Katie. Intriguing for you, as they say. Yeah, that's what you can say, as they say. Oh, it's gonna be like this, where every fight's gonna count as one. That's fun and exciting, I guess. Well, depending how you consider fun and exciting. I'm tempted to cut some of these battles out, but I guess, like, for this first video, it might as well just be a fully rambling video. With, potentially microphone normalization and some EQ and some other stuff that I've been wanting to test out. I mean, I could just get lazy and just not, like, at all try or go ahead and use the multi-track audio thing that I've been trying to test out and work with. Like, if out of nowhere it works, it's not really good. It should be in concept, though. I don't know, I've lost track. Either way, there's a thing called video editors that will solve the issues. Maybe we'll just make the first episode really long. I don't know. Like, I can cut this up in any way I want. Like, there's no, like, specific requirement on how I'm supposed to record and edit videos. I can do it however I want. Like, that's the way that goes. We'll just hit. I don't think we're gonna hit. Actually, we're probably not gonna do anything productive in the hitting now. That's interesting, Katie. If you want to talk about, well, you don't have to talk about it. Seems a weird personal issues and IRL stuff, but, you know, Discord's always a place you can do that if you don't trust people on the Twitch stream, or if you do, then do whatever. Yeah, that's an awkward situation, though.
It's time to confuse tech.
People on Discord are very friendly, apparently. If anybody can help Lit AD, that'd be really nice. Like, you don't have to help me. I would prefer if you guys help each other. That's the point of the streams, to help each other and build a community. Rain of Fires, how are you, man? Hope you're doing well. And it's really the point of the streams, if you're unaware of what my idea set is, to help out each other. Such people are awesome. They really are. You beat Shadow, Mewtwo, and Pokin. I feel like a part of me died. Really? I didn't know a Shadow and Mewtwo existed, but I don't know much about Pokemon, so whatever. You saw Jabberwock? Yeah, that happens. Yeah, sometimes that is. Hello to you, Alyssa Love 217. How are you? Hope you're doing well. I need to change my title to be accurate. Azteca, fun, plus testing out awesome YouTube recording setup thing. Or setup. Sure. Now people know that I actually am doing a YouTube video thing. Because I want to have more content on YouTube, and this is a good way to have some content going up on YouTube. Yeah, Kambuzu likes 20 times. I like it. But I hope you've been doing well, also. This guy off work, nice. Hope it was a fun day at work, if it was, but if it... And cool, if it wasn't, then I hope that your time home will be great. If that's a thing. I'm not aware of what your life is, so I'm just assuming the best. And it's still real nice. I love the Ortheris realm, such a beautiful, elegant realm that we've been on for like years in this game. And it's kind of what we just do.
Shipley wants charcoal? That fool. Does he want to burn us all to our end before the comet strikes us down?
Yes, yes, you can have some. But I dropped it in my rush to get to safety. You'll have to collect it from 3 points on your own.
Don't worry, that's easy. Summer Clash, nothing's official about it yet, other than we want to do it, but we haven't talked about rule sets and stuff on the server that we talk about that on Discord. Like, we're gonna do it eventually, and we were gonna do some Steam stuff like a week ago, but the issue was I had school stuff, and then I wasn't that motivated to continue with the conversations. We may talk about it later today, I don't know. Like, after I get tired of doing questing, we may just go on discussions about those things. Which would be pretty cool, I guess, to do. But for now, we're just going to go and chill out. And then when we get to Summer Clash, we'll at least talk about the possibility and how that's going to work. And we'll do that. But, like, when it's official, we'll have a video, YouTube video. We'll have all sorts of sources. We'll have DualCircle.com working out well and all that stuff. I need to make a DualCircle video, too. So many videos I got to make. But it's just spring break, so it should be good.
You've got everything? Now with the salt of stone, the charcoal, and the lovely sulfur, we can make a strong concoction. Smells lovely, doesn't it? Take this carefully, carefully. And when you get close to the rubble, throw it hard and then run for your life. Boom! move back a safe distance. Then find Tescat 3-star in Cenote. I hope he isn't standing too close. Boom! Big bada boom!
Yeah, that guy's great. I love it.
That's a lot of rubble to clear to get into the mall.
Oh, hi, Phone. How are you?
You hope Shipley's strong concoction lives up to its name. It sure smells strong, like rotten eggs. You throw the strong concoction with all your might, and then hunker down for safety. That was a big bada boom. As the smoke and dust clear, you can see a path into the mall.
Yeah, let's go into the mall. I'll answer some of the questions in chat later. In due time. But we're gonna go talk to this guy in the video, and then we'll go on to the next part, since I think this is long enough for the beginning of Azteca, the rambling, the battles, all that stuff, and it gives us a good opportunity to have that. So we're gonna end it here before we talk to him, just so that, like, the next video we'll have all the Cenote area stuff that we gotta do, or at least the first part of Cenote and whatnot. We'll have that done for the episode 2 of the Azteca Let's Play Reno. Thank you everybody for watching. Make sure you go ahead and like this video if you like it. Subscribe if you love my content or just my personality. Check out my Twitter down below. Also check out my Discord server if you're into Discord and stuff. Over there, it's a Quantum server, beautiful place, lots of cool people. Hang out with us there. Also check me on Twitch too if you liked live streams and stuff, if you like my personality, you like to see me live, or just more content in general on Twitch just because it's easier for me to stream, and also less video editing and things that I do with that. Live shows are fun things, so let's just say that. Anyways, thanks everybody for watching. I will see you into the episode 2, and have a good one all, and I will see you within the future.